Hey everyone, welcome to homeschool. Hope everybody are doing good. And I have come up with solving model question paper for class 10 for 2023 batch. I mean the students who are going to write Karnataka Board SSLC examination. See, in yesterday's video I covered all the questions that came under part A, right? So all physics questions we have discussed yesterday and have taught you how to write the answers and how to present the answers and the entire concepts that came in and around the question, right? And this is the second part of a video where I'm going to deal with part B, okay? So already I gave an idea about the three parts, right? Part A was physics, part B is chemistry, and next part is part C, which includes biology related questions. And so in today's video, let me talk about all chemistry questions which come under part B. So the chemistry questions will start from 6th main onwards, right from 14th question. So even in chemistry part, you have MCQs, 1 mark, 2 markers, 3 markers and 4 markers. So let us quickly go for the MCQs. That is the 14th question. The chemical equation that represent neutralization reaction among the following. So we all very well know that neutralization reaction is the reaction between an acid and base, right? So whenever an acid reacts with a base, you will get salt plus water, and neutralization reactions are exothermic in nature. So there are four options given and you have to select which is a neutralization reaction. Look at the option A. They said sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH, reacted with hydrochloric acid, that means HCl. And what are the products that you got? NaCl is one product and H2O is another product. So definitely this is a neutralization reaction, isn't it? NaOH is a base, HCl is an acid. See, acid reacting with a base and you are getting salt, that is NaCl and H2O. So definitely option A is the correct answer for 14th question. And 15th question, it is based on a definition from periodic classification of elements. Properties of elements are periodic functions of their atomic number. This law was proposed by, so this is a modern periodic law definition, right? See, properties of elements are periodic properties of their atomic number. This is called modern periodic law. Modern periodic law was introduced by Henry Moseley, isn't it? So which is the correct option? Option D. So for 15th question, option D, Henry Moseley is correct answer. Coming to question number 16. The substance that converts red litmus paper into blue. Okay. So what they asked you is something that is converting red litmus paper to blue. So if it is a base, okay, when you dip red litmus paper into a base, then red color gets converted into blue, isn't it? Then from the options, you have to select the compound which acts as a base. Look at option A, KOH solution. So KOH is base. Option B, distilled water. Distilled water do not change the color of a litmus paper, right? Third option, dilute HCl solution. HCl is acid. It will convert red to red itself. Concentrated solution of HNO3. HNO3 is also acid, so red remains red itself. But for option A, which is nothing but a KOH solution, since it is base, it will definitely convert red litmus paper into blue. Okay, so all these conversions you should know. I mean, which one converts red to blue, which one converts blue to red, and what happens if acid is, if acid is added to phenolphthalein or methyl orange when added to acid or base, what is the color change? So all that you should be careful with. Okay, so if you want an idea about the indicators and how the colors changes, you can watch the playlist of the chapter acid, bases and salt. Okay, so you will get an entire idea about acids, bases and salt. So that's all about question number 16. Coming to question number 17. Okay, so here 17, 18 and 19 are 1 mark questions. Okay, so let us talk about 17th question now. Mention the number of single bonds and double bonds present in structure of C2H5COOH molecule. So C2H5COOH. So this is a formula they have given, and they are asking you how many sigma and pi bonds are present. Okay, so first you have to write its elaborate structure. C2H5 in the sense it is CH3CH2 group. CH3CH2 together you can combine and write it as C2H5 because two carbons, so C2, five hydrogens together H5. Okay, so COOH. So if you expand and write, how do you write? So CH3 you will write it like this, three hydrogens. CH2 here one H, here one H. COOH if you expand and write, it is C double bond O OH, right? So this is the complete structure of C2H5COOH. And now count number of single bonds and double bonds. So this is a double bond, right? So double bonds are one. So how many double bonds are present? There is one double bond. And total number of single bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? 8, 9. Single bonds are 9. Single bonds are 9. Okay, so that is your answer. And 18th question, very easy question. Write the electron dot structure of methane. So methane is CH4. So how do you write its dot structure? C you will write at the center. And four hydrogen atoms like this, right? And each hydrogen has got one valence electron. Carbon has got four valence electrons. And you will show sharing. So two hydrogens will come like this. Okay, I mean, this is how hydrogen atoms will share the electrons. And for carbon, you have to show eight electrons around. Okay, so this is the dot structure of CH4. And 19th question is a diagram. Draw the diagram of an arrangement of apparatus to show electrolysis of water. So electrolysis of water comes in a first chapter, that is chemical reactions and equations. You have to neatly draw the diagram and label all the components, which is cathode, which is anode, where do you get hydrogen, where is oxygen liberated, everything you have to label in a proper way. Okay, and now let us go for question number 20, 21 and 22. All three questions carry 2 marks each. Okay, so let's talk about question number 20 now. See, this question 20 is very simple. Calcium oxide reacts with water to form slaked lime. So let us try to write the equation. Calcium oxide, that is CaO, which is also called as quicklime. This calcium oxide is reacting with water. So it's a very famous reaction. Whenever quicklime is added to water, you will get calcium hydroxide. Right, and along with that, large amount of heat is liberated. Okay, what type of chemical reaction is this? See, since large amount of heat is liberating, you can call this reaction as exothermic reaction. This is an example for exothermic reaction, or it can be an example for combination reaction also. So how do you call it as a combination reaction? Because look at here, there are two reactants which are reacting to give a single product. This you should not consider as a product. Only the chemical compounds have to be considered as the product. Okay. So reactants, when two or more combine to give a single product, then it can be called as combination reaction. So either one, either exothermic or combination, you can mention. Write the balanced chemical equation for this. Already I have written equation which is balanced. One calcium, two hydrogens here, yes, two hydrogens, and this one oxygen plus one, two this side and two oxygens. Okay, it's already a balanced equation. So very simple question, right? Okay, so now let us go for question number 21. What is the chemical name of bleaching powder? Write any two uses of it. Chemical name of bleaching powder. So bleaching powder, CaOCl2, this is a formula. This can be called as calcium oxychloride. Calcium oxychloride. Or this can also be called as calcium hypochlorite. Hypochlorite. Calcium oxychloride or calcium hypochlorite. Fine. And they are also asking any two uses of it. So this can be used for bleaching. Used for bleaching. Name itself has bleaching action. Removes color, right? So it is used for bleaching silk and wool. Silk and wool. And another thing, it can also be used as disinfectant. Disinfectant. Okay, in the sterilization of water. So these two uses you can mention. And there is OR question here. For 21 you have this OR question. What is concentrated acid? Name the acid present in the stinging hair of nettle leaves. The concentrated acid is the one which has more number of H plus ions. More number of H plus ions. Any acid which has got more number of H plus ions can be called as concentrated acid. Okay. And name the acid present in the stinging hair of nettle leaves. It is methanoic acid. So methanoic acid is present in the stinging hair of nettle leaves. So in NCERT textbook, you have that small table. Like which acid is present in which source. Like in tomato, it is oxalic acid, right? In tamarind, it is tartaric acid. You know, that table is very, very important. Fine. So now let us go for question number 22. This is also a very simple question. Give reasons. See, from the chapter metals and nonmetals, give reason type of questions are very common. So from textbook, from each and every line, you should know the concept. Okay, only then you can attempt give reason type of questions. So here there are two questions here. Give reason why ionic compounds have high melting and boiling points. Okay, so ionic compounds have high melting and boiling points because ionic compounds have strong electrostatic force of attraction. Strong electrostatic forces of attraction between the ions. Okay, that is why they will show very high melting and boiling points. Next question, ionic compounds in solid state do not conduct electricity. Okay, see, in solid state ions do not move. In solid state ions do not move, right? Only in the molten state and liquid state ions move. That is why ionic compound conducts electricity in molten state and liquid state, whereas in solid state ions do not move. Ions are not free, or you can write ions are not free. Okay, so that is all about two more questions. And now coming to three mark questions. So question number 23 is again a diagram. Draw the diagram of the arrangement of apparatus to show the action of steam on metals. See, and you have to label metal piece and delivery tube. So this is the diagram from metals and non-metals chapter. So you can just practice. And coming to question number 24 from the chapter periodic classification of elements. Okay. The electronic configuration of four elements are given below. Write the elements in the increasing order of their electropositivity and give reason. Okay. See, electropositivity in the sense metallic nature. Ability of an element to give electrons easily is called metallic nature. And that metallic nature is directly proportional to atomic size. If an element is larger in size, then it can act as metallic in nature. Okay. So what are the elements present here? Sodium is there, sulfur is there, aluminium is there, potassium is there. So you have to arrange these elements in the increasing order of their metallic nature. So you look at the connection. Metallic nature is directly proportional to size. If size more, more metallic. Okay, so increasing order, less metallic to more metallic side you have to arrange. That means less size to more size, smaller size to bigger size. So among them, which is a smaller size? Definitely sulfur. Sulfur is smallest. And after that, aluminium, right? And after aluminium, it is sodium. Look at here, sulfur belongs to 16th group, aluminium 13th group, sodium first group, potassium first group. So 16th group, so as you go from left to right, size will decrease, isn't it? So smallest element is sulfur. Since the size is small, less metallic. Next element is aluminium. So after that, little bigger element is sodium. So the biggest element is potassium. Okay. So since sulfur is smallest, it is less metallic. Since potassium is largest in size, it is more metallic. Okay, so this is the increasing order of their increasing electropositivity. Give reason, they said, because size increases. Okay, as size increases, metallic nature increases. So this is your reason. Clear? Very conceptual one. All these questions you can attempt only if you know the concept. So if you want to have a concept clarity, definitely do visit our playlist that is available in our channel. Now let us quickly go to question number 25. Silver chloride when exposed to the sunlight turns grey color. Why? Silver chloride, AgCl, when it is exposed to sunlight, it turns to grey color because it will undergo decomposition to give silver. Silver is grey color powder plus Cl2. So how do you balance? Always whenever you write a chemical equation, you should definitely write the balanced equations. Okay. So this is the reaction that takes place. Why they are asking? Why? Because this silver chloride decomposes to silver chloride, that is AgCl decomposes to silver. Ag is grey color. Ag is grey colored powder. Okay, fine. Write the balanced chemical equation. Yes, we have already written. And mention the type of reaction. Which type of reaction it is? It is photochemical decomposition. So you have to write, it is photochemical decomposition reaction. Okay, so very, very important. Decomposition reactions are three types, isn't it? Thermal decomposition, photochemical decomposition and electrolysis. So all the three are very, very important and remember them along with the examples. And there is our question here. This is also very simple. Why does the color of copper sulfate solution changes when an iron nail is dipped into it? Write the balanced chemical equation for this reaction. So definitely iron nail, that is iron, when dipped in copper sulfate is blue color solution. Since iron is more reactive than copper, iron is more reactive than copper. What happens? Iron displaces copper from copper sulfate solution. Okay, so if iron comes in the place of copper, what do you get? You will get FeSO4 plus copper. So this is the chemical reaction. Write the balanced chemical equation for this reaction. Yes, so this is a balanced equation and this is the reason. Very simple, isn't it? Next, coming to the last question under chemistry part, which is a 4-marker question. So again, here you have A question and B question. So coming to question number A, the conversion of ethanol to ethanoic acid is an oxidation reaction. Why? So first you write the chemical equation. Ethanol. Ethanol is what? CH3CH2OH. So this one, when added in presence of KMnO4 and sulfuric acid, you will get CH3COOH. This is called ethanol, right? And this is called ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid. So definitely this is an oxidation reaction because addition of oxygen is involved. Look at the difference here. If you remove this hydrogen and instead of that, if you add oxygen, you will get ethanoic acid. Okay. So this is oxidation reaction because, you have to write this way, because addition of oxygen and removal of hydrogen is involved. Okay, so this is called as oxidation reaction. Okay, you have to write the equation and then mention this sentence and that will be a complete answer. And coming to B question, what are structural isomers? Write the structural isomers of butane. So the isomers which have same molecular formula but different structure, isn't it? The isomers which have same molecular formula. I'll write it in a shortcut. MF in the sense molecular formula but different structures are called as structural isomers. And they are asking you to write the structural isomers of which one? Butane, right? So I'm writing here I'll write CH3 CH2 CH2 CH3. So this is one butane. And another way of writing butane is this, right? So this is just butane we will call, and this can be called as isobutane. Structure different, but same number of carbon atoms and same number of hydrogen atoms. Okay, so that is all about the chemistry part. Okay, and in the next video I will come up with biology part and I'll write the answers of bio question point by point. Okay, because see, chemistry part you don't have too much to write, just a chemical equation is your answer and just the reason in this kind of sentences you can write and finish. Okay, but bio part you have to write the paragraph type of answers. I mean to say point wise you have to mention the answer. So presentation of answers is very, very important under bio part. Okay, so in the next video I will teach you how to present the answers for bio questions. So thank you so much. Share this video to the maximum friends possible. Let everyone get benefit out of it. Keep learning and all the best.